another amazing recipe. I am so excited yet another day because today at the Young's house, Gina Young is going to share with you all how easy it is to make Hawaiian chicken. This Hawaiian chicken right here, pretty much bomb. So easy to make, doesn't require a lot of ingredients, and if you make it Gina Young style, it's going to be so tasty. Y'all never had my Hawaiian chicken before. You better make you some. Here are the lovely ingredients you will need. We have some beautiful thin chicken breast that I have washed off with lime juice, salt, and coke water, and then we pat it dry. But now listen here, any pieces of the chicken that you would like to use, you can use. If you wanted to use boneless, skinless chicken thighs or the wings, like have fun with whatever piece of meat that you would like to use. You're gonna need some pineapple, and I decided to use the pineapple in the can. You can use fresh if you wanted to, but I like the pineapple in the can, so that's what we have here, and we will be using the juice from the can as well. And over here, we have some frozen mangoes that have been thawed out, so they are nice and thawed out. We're gonna have our Hawaiian chicken with white rice underneath it or on the side, and a couple of spices so we can make this dish taste delicious. So right here we have some paprika, some black pepper, we have some pollo asado seasoning, and then we have parsley flakes and cornstarch. And in my pan I have just a little bit of vegetable oil. Make sure your hands are impeccably clean. Let's get started with this really quick and simple, yet so tasty recipe. So now before we address our chicken, I do want to talk about this new spice that I'm using. This is a new spice that I've never tried before, but of course I've opened it and I'm really excited to use it. And I did kind of like wet my finger and, you know, get some stuck on my finger, and I tasted it and I feel like I'm gonna love the spice. So what we'll do is we'll learn together if this is a delicious spice. And what I do when I'm trying to figure out like if I would like something or not, I look on the label to see what ingredients are in it. And by a San Polo Asado seasoning, sounds like something that I would like, because polo means chicken, and I'm thinking that it's a chicken flavoring. So it has salt, garlic, sugar, spices, it has paprika, turmeric, and it has cumin and white pepper and annatto seed and onion powder. So I'm really excited to try this on this dish today. All right, so now what I wanna do is I wanna break my chicken down a little bit. You are going to be using a boneless, skinless chicken, you know. Like I said, you can use the breast, but you can also use wings that, you know, you would of course have the bone and the skin on. So we're kind of chopping it down like that, okay? If you wanted to chop yours down smaller, absolutely you could, all right? And what we're gonna do, I wanna try to make this light and airy. I'm not gonna put a breading on it. And I think this is gonna be really, really interesting, okay? Someone was asking for this recipe and I said, you know what, gonna do it today. I'm making the Hawaiian chicken and we are gonna see how it turns out together. And I just feel like it's gonna be beautiful. All right, it's been a while since I made Hawaiian chicken. And I don't remember how I made it last time. So we're just gonna kind of wing it. We're gonna kind of wing it and do it together. You know, you just have to do that with life. You know, if you're not sure about something, just jump out there, knowing that with God on your side, you can do all things. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me, and you can too. And especially in the kitchen, just ask God for a little bit of assistance, and you'll get the assistance. All right, so now that we have some beautiful chicken chunks here, I'm gonna, if you stay right there, I just wanna wash my hands up really quickly, all right, and then what we're gonna do is let's go ahead and season. We're gonna put some paprika on, just like so in this manner. We're gonna put some black pepper. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Okay, and we're gonna put our pollo seasoning on there. I'm gonna be kind of generous with it. All right, and then we're gonna put some parsley flakes just to make it nice and beautiful. And then I wanna go in and I'm gonna mix everything together. This dish should be very quick and simple. All right, we're gonna let these seasonings kind of seep down into this beautiful protein for at least 12 minutes. And when I come back, I'll show you what we'll do next. So now that our chicken has set for about 12 minutes with the spices all over it, let's go ahead and put it into our pan. And if you take a look into our pan, I'm gonna show you just about how much oil I have. You can see it's not a whole lot. We're not trying to deep fry this, but just a little bit of oil, about that much, just so we can get it nice, beautiful, and golden brown. And hopefully you can hear and see that sizzle. If you don't see it, don't put any more in. Your pan must be nice and hot in order for you to get a beautiful sear onto it and the perfect cook. Okay? All right. Beautiful fresh chicken here. I hope that you all are having an amazing day today. Let me know in the comment section below, have you ever tried Hawaiian chicken before? I'm so excited to make this recipe. Like I said, with this recipe, I'm kind of just winging it today. We're just gonna figure out how to do it because I cannot remember how I made it last time. But I tell you what, I guarantee it's gonna be delicious. But we'll find out today. We will find out today. So what I'm going to do right now is start to make up a cornstarch slurry. The cornstarch slurry is going to make up an Hawaiian sauce that's going to be absolutely delicious. So I figured what we're going to do is we're going to use two different fruits that give you like that Hawaiian taste. Of course, number one would be your pineapples and number two would be your mango chunks. But I want you all, when we think about the mango is already soft. So we're going to throw the mango in like as an afterthought at the last minute, right before we get ready to turn the dish off, because we don't want the mangoes to turn to mush. We want them to let off beautiful flavor as it will, but we don't want to put it in too early. Here's what we're going to do. I'm going to take this beautiful juice. This is why I decided to use the pineapple in the can, because it has this gorgeous juice. You know, and if you were to use a fresh pineapple, you're not gonna get that beautiful juice. So now that I have juice there, let's go ahead and put it here in this bowl, okay? Let's go ahead and make up our cornstarch slurry. We're gonna start out with 2 tablespoons, and this is just a house tablespoon, not a measuring spoon, okay? Cornstarch, beautiful. And then we're going to add pineapple juice to it. Get it nice and loosened up. And this right here is gonna be our thickener. So all throughout this beautiful dish, you're gonna taste these amazing Hawaiian flavors. It's gonna knock your socks off. And I am so excited. So here's what it looks like once you get it nice and mixed up. Now, if we take a look over at our chicken, I feel like we're getting some beautiful pieces here that should by now have some nice color to them. Let's start turning them over. Oh yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Chicken can be delicious without a coating, without breading. You don't always need breading on your chicken for it to be delicious. Please keep that in mind, okay? Because I make so many dishes where I don't use a flour, I don't use cornstarch or cornmeal to bread it, and it's always succulent and delicious. The key to making successful chicken is making sure that your pan is nice and hot and that you don't overcook your chicken. Okay, so I'm gonna continue to turn all of these pieces of chicken over, and when I come back, I'll show you what we're gonna do next. Since we're going Hawaiian, I wanted to try this dragon fruit for the first time. It's a lot of firsts today. Okay, we're gonna try this dragon fruit together. Let's go ahead and get it nice and opened up so that we can reveal the beautiful flesh that's inside. So we're going to, cut the ends off just like so, in this manner. And then we're gonna put a slice here. Don't go down too far, all right? And then we are going to peel this part off, all right? Look at like this. God is amazing because this fruit is simply beautiful. And you know what? Believe it or not, it was so easy to peel this, right? Okay, so we're gonna discard of this and then we are going to slice some chunks. And what I feel like is, look at that gorgeous reveal. Okay, I wanna slice and dice some nice chunks, and we'll have something nice and refreshed to eat alongside of our Hawaiian chicken. We're going all out, we're really making it Hawaiian. Look at that, look how beautiful. Ooh-wee. Let's put it on this plate for the time being. And meanwhile, while I get this onto the plate, what you guys can do is take a look over at the chicken, because our chicken is almost done. My whole kitchen smells so good, and the chicken looks nice and tender. This right here, that's what I'm looking for. We want to give this chicken about, let's just say, 5 to 7 more minutes to cook until it's completely cooked. And then what we're going to do is we're going to turn around and take some of the pineapple juice from this can and pour it over top of our chicken. But there is some liquid in the bottom of the pan. I don't want you guys to pour it out. I want you to leave that in there. It's going to give great flavor to your sauce. Now that our chicken is perfectly done, and it's very important that, like I said in the beginning of the video, that you don't use a whole lot of oil, because that little bit, we're going to keep it in there as for flavor. So let's go ahead and put a can of our pineapple juice in. And pineapples, your desired amount of pineapples that you would like to have. I feel like that's the perfect amount. All right, look at this, and we're gonna bring this, turn it up to like medium high, and we just want that pineapple flavor to permeate all through this beautiful chicken, just like so. Meanwhile, I'd like to put a little bit more of this chicken powder in here, just a little bit, okay? Because I wanna season those pineapples, and I do wanna put some black pepper in. We're gonna bring this up to a slight boil. Once we get it up to a slight boil, what we're going to do is we're going to then put our cornstarch slurry in to thicken this up. This is, of course, parsley flakes, just to make it nice and beautiful. And let's talk about our fruit here. So now, I know I said we'll try it together. This right here was a no-go for me. No, ma'am. No, ma'am. Am I going to try it for you guys? Nope. No, ma'am. No, I can't. I didn't like it. Let me know in the comment section below if you guys like dragon fruit or if I cut it wrong or something. But I did look online how to cut it. This is how they said to cut it when I tasted it. I was just going to eat this alongside as a fresh fruit, you know, like in a little tiny bowl. But when I tried it, it tastes like it had no flavor. It wasn't sweet. It wasn't salty. It wasn't tangy. It wasn't crunchy, it's kind of soft, and it tastes like thickened water. I don't like this fruit. So you guys always ask me, Gina, what don't you like? I don't like dragon fruit. So this is a no-go. All right, we're gonna let this simmer down just for a little bit, and then when we come back, we're gonna be thickening up our Hawaiian chicken, Gina Young style. So now our chicken has been simmering down for at least, I wanna say 15 minutes or so. The sauce has reduced. The whole house smells good. We have to try the sauce because you wanna know what you're feeding to your loved ones. And if you need to reseason, now's the perfect time after you taste it. Let's see what the sauce tastes like. Let's see what it tastes like together. Oh my goodness. Listen here, that flavor right there, out of sight, so delicious. You can taste the tanginess from the pineapple. You can taste the sweetness. You can taste all of the beautiful seasonings that we put into the chicken. I'm excited about this. Now's the perfect time to put your thickening agent in so we can thicken up this beautiful sauce as if it was kind of like a sweet and sour sauce. But you know, we're not making sweet and sour sauce. Look at this. Oh, beautiful. The chicken looks nice and tender. And literally, right before our own eyes, when I come back, everything will be nice and thickened up. It's thickening up right now, if you can see. Look at that. Like a beautiful chicken Hawaiian glaze. Look at that. So succulent. Okay, so I'll come right back. And when I come back, I'm going to tell you the perfect amount of mango chunks to put in and when to put it in. Our sauce has thickened up. I've turned the burner off, and next we're gonna put in some mango chunks that have been thawed out. Now listen here, if you have fresh mango, you know, of course you don't have to thaw it out. Put your desired amount in here. Look at this. Oh, fresh mango, look at that. Listen here. This right here is Hawaiian chicken 101. So delicious. I cannot wait to try this. The whole house smells good, beautiful. Look at that. Look at the sauce. Look at the sauce. That's a sauce. Ooh. And look at the chicken. Look at the chicken. Look at the chicken. You got to see that chicken. Ooh, me and umai. All right, the rice is done. Nice, perfect, and fluffy. Listen here, everybody. My mouth is salivating. If y'all enjoyed this video, give me a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed, make sure you subscribe. Tell your family and friends and everyone you know. Tell the whole world about Gina Young, what I'm doing in this kitchen on a daily basis. Let's go ahead and say a prayer now so we can taste this. Heavenly Father, we'd like to thank you once again for a beautiful day. Lord, we thank you for your love time, your mercy, and your understanding. Please forgive us for our sins. Come into our hearts. We make you our Lord and Savior. Send your angels down to surround us day and night. Your Holy Spirit to help us make good decisions. Give us peace of our minds. In the name of Jesus, we pray that no weapons formed against us shall prosper. And we bind the devil away from us in Jesus' name. Devil, you have no authority over this household. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the roof over our head, the food, the love, the peace and the joy you bring us every day. Amen. Take a look at it, everybody. Gina Young style homemade Hawaiian chicken. Make you some white rice on the side. Amen once again to my beautiful prayer. Come on in so you can have a bite. I know. I'm going to give you some. First thing I want to do, I got to let you taste the sauce. The sauce, the fruit, and the rice. So there's that. Look at this. Look at it. And now we're going in for a piece of that chicken. Look at the chicken. It's so succulent. I'm going to slice down into a piece of it. Let's see. I just have to have you all look in the inside. You got to see it. Look at that. Nice and moist and so flavorful. Take your last bite, guys. I'm going to put a piece of fruit on there. And as always, thank you all. Thank you all for watching.